Pointers in a paddock, get my peace, push and pee. Pointers in a paddock, get my peace, push and pee. What's up, guys? I'm Drake Rock. Today we have Gunna's actual vocal chain that his mixing engineer Baines used on his mix. We're going to be covering his new song Push and Pee, which is off Drip Season 4, just dropped last night. And this is a template that you can get for FL Studio that I've recreated from his actual vocal chain. You guys can download it right now, link in the description. So head over to drakerock.com/shop and it will be the first one in the store. So we're going to be dissecting all of this today and going into it. If you get the template, this is going to include the whole session, the master, all the sends, all the effects, all the everything, as well as the beat and the raw vocals, so you can play around with my mix as well. And you can just pop this in, save it as a template, and record your own songs to it. So let's get started and hear what it sounds like before and after.
Pointers in a paddock, get my peace, push and pee. Cop new hammers for my pee, we don't want no peace.
And here's after.
Pointers in a paddock, get my peace, push and pee. Cop new hammers for my pee, we don't want no peace. Got a spot across the spot, yeah, just for peace. Drop the dot and then we plot, yeah, exotic peace. Yeah, yeah. Off Capitol P, I rock these presidents, count presidents. Portuguese on her knees, my banana pee. She let me squeeze, then she leaves, so I keep the pee. Yeah, keep the pee, yeah, keep the pee.
Okay, so there's our mix, and as you can see, I put in some melodic stuff right here, as well as some kind of Playboi Carti type vocals, just to get a variation and show you guys what the template is going to sound like with different types of vocals. So we're going to dive into this. So I recorded this on the Slate ML1, which is this mic right here, and I used Virtual Mix Rack, and that's going to be on the recording section here, and that emulates different microphones. But that is not on here because I'm assuming you guys won't be using that mic. So we're starting off the vocal chain with a 2A. So normally, if you're in a studio, they're going to have compressors and preamps that the mic is going to go and feed through before the chain gets sent into Pro Tools, for example. So what they normally start out with is a compressor, and this is just going to level it out and give you that kind of clean mix from the mic. And from there, they can add maybe like de-essers, EQ, maybe auto-tune. They'll print that on sometimes, but normally there's always a compressor. So make sure you have a compressor, just doing it slight. If you don't have the 2A, you can use any non-tonal compression that kind of gets that same leveling out effect, pretty soft. So that's just gonna hit at about -3 decibels when we're recording. So in this template, we're going to go into our vocal chain, show you what we got. Per usual, and I'm not going to cover this, we have our noise suppression. This is going to take out any ambisonics. I recorded this in a closet, so there was a lot of kind of echoey boxiness. So we're taking it down like 30, and this is going to be noise suppression in that sense. Next, we have our auto-tune. So obviously, we're going to have our auto-tune on every track set to the key, set to our presets, and low latency so it doesn't kind of spaz out and delay us. We have 3 retune speed, a little bit of flex tune, and 45 humanize. No vibrato, no anything else. Everything's default. So just typical auto-tune. If you don't have auto-tune, just use whatever tuner you want. You can use Melodyne or Pitcher, or if you're in Logic, use the built-in stock auto-tune. So next we have a FabFilter Pro Q3. So this is what Baines uses on the mix. And what I'm doing is I'm doing a little bit heavier lows here because it was boxy. Like I said, I recorded it in the closet. But normally what his template would sound like is something like this. Okay, so he'll do a little cut. He's going to do a sharp cut right here at 100. And we're also going to cut a little bit out at these PRC frequencies, 10K and about 3K as well. So that's going to be there. We're going to pull it down for our mix just so we get that boxiness out. And that's our basic EQ. The goal with the EQ is to keep it as clean as we can while not muddying too much of the vocal. So I'm going to turn off these plugins and let's listen to the vocal.
Pointers in a paddock, get my peace, push and pee. Cop new hammers for my pee, we don't want no peace. Got a spot across the spot, yeah, just for peace.
Okay, so you can see we're cutting out the lows and it's sounding good, crisp. We're cutting out that boxiness too, but it's not too much. It's just kind of a dry vocal. So next step is we're gonna do some de-essing, just normal de-essing on that. We're gonna have a fresh air, free plugin from Slate, boosting here the highs a little bit. This next one is the secret sauce, is from Plugin Alliance. This is their vocal enhancer. There's our settings for that, and that's going to add a little bit of saturation, which is really nice for our vocal. Again, this is all what Baines uses on his vocals and his mixing templates, and you can all look this up online as well if you want to double check. So next we're going into an R compressor, and this is going here to 227, negative 13 threshold, going up gain a little bit, 3 decibels. We're doing a fast attack and a normal release. That's just going to give us more leveling out, and if we play the vocal with all of that so far, then listen what it sounds like.
Pointers in a paddock, in my piece, pushing P. Cop new hammers for my P, we don't want no peace. Got a spot across the spot, yeah, just for peace.
Okay, so it's sounding good, but the thing we have to do left, and again, when we have these loud parts.
Off capital P, I rock these presidents, count presidents.
Okay.
Keep the P, keep the P, yeah, stay on it, right.
Right, it's sounding nice and compressed and leveled and clean, but it doesn't sound polished and kind of a final mix yet. So what we're gonna have next is a Mag EQ4. You can use any EQ like this that you want. This is just a really good, and they have this air knob that everyone raves about. Instead of fresh air, he uses a different plugin that kind of provides that air effect. But we're using this because it's a free alternative and it just a good a job, if not better. So next we have that EQ right here. These are our settings. It's giving a little boost. Listen to this.
Like these presidents, count presidents. Portuguese on her knees, my banana pee.
Right, so we're boosting the highs a little bit and kind of getting a little bit more EQ, cutting the lows and kind of adding some of that highness. If you feel like it's too much, you can pull it back up or maybe pull these down.
Like these presidents, count presidents.
A little warm for me.
Like these presidents, count presidents.
Sounds good to me. Okay, so next we have a 76. He uses the vintage compressors. He does not like the CLA or just the modern 76s. But these are about the settings that he uses. And again, you have to adjust this to your vocal to see kind of how much it's going to compress. So watch this.
Like these presidents, count presidents. Portuguese on her knees, my banana pee.
Right, it's going to cut three, but in these higher parts, it's going to do a little more. So it's going to come down like negative 3 decibels, and that's going to provide like a really nice leveling to our mix. So we have a de-esser after that. We'll turn that on. Next is we have a secret sauce to any mix if you're looking to kind of polish it up. So here's our vocals.
Spot it, spot it, cross the spot. Yeah, just for peace.
So a multi-band compressor is going to be massive in changing the way that your vocal sounds. So we're using a C4. You could use a C6 as well. And we're kind of pulling down the lows just a little bit on the slider, bumping the highs a little bit, but not the too high shelf because it's going to be a little bit too piercy. But we're really watching these mids. Okay, so watch this.
Got a spot across the spot, yeah, just for peace.
Okay, if I turn this on, watch this.
Got a spot across the spot, yeah, just for peace. Drop the dot and then we plot, yeah, exotic peace.
Okay, so it sounds a little bit boxy, but it sounds tight and nice, kind of polished. Again, we're boosting the gain as well. And let's play this with a beat because that's how you want to hear it.
Got a spot across the spot, yeah, just for peace. Drop the dot and then we plot, yeah, exotic peace.
So if you want to change the way your vocal sounds and make it not so boxy, or you want more bass, if you want more bass, kind of pull these up. So listen.
Pointers in a paddock, get my piece, pushing P. Cop new hammers for my P.
Right, and then if we want the mids, the low mids right here, we're gonna use this slider and pull it up.
Pointers in a
listen.
Spot across the spot, yeah, just for peace.
Okay, that's normal. Let's boost this up a little bit. Take that down where it was.
Spot across the spot, yeah, just for peace. Drop the dot and then we plot, yeah, exotic peace. Yeah.
Okay, so we're trying to like find the middle ground here. This is a good area. And what Baines does is he boosts this right here in his C6. He boosts this up and you're gonna see him pull it up. So we're gonna keep it right about there. That's what he does for Gunna. Again, Gunna has a different tone than me for the vocals, so it's a little bit different. But you mix to your voice and don't try to copy exactly the artist anyway. So
got a spot across the spot, yeah, just for peace. Drop the dot and then we plot, yeah, exotic peace.
Finding the midpoint is finding the vocal that has presence in the beat, but it also doesn't cut out too much, right? So it could sound tinny, but it could sound fitting in the beat then. But if you add more of the boxiness, you can hear it better, but it doesn't really fit. So you got to find that middle ground. So last thing is optional. This is Soothe. This is a plugin from Oak Sound or Oaky Sound, whatever. So this is the D-Honk preset for vocals. This is just a godsend plugin. You do not need it. There's a couple free alternatives. There's Maximus or something like that. And that's a free one that you can download, just free multiband compressors. So this is going to do a really good job of dynamic EQ. So watch this.
Pointers in a paddock, get my piece, pushing P.
If we dial that up, it's going to cut everything out. And we're taking out some of these boxiness, right? Because we're coming in kind of boxy. So if we play with this depth, which is the amount, listen to how it sounds. Sorry.
Get my peace, pushing P. Cop new hammers for my P. We don't want no peace. Got a spot across the spot, yeah, just for peace. Drop the dot and then we plot, yeah, exotic peace.
Okay. Yeah. So we're bouncing into maybe a little bit overcompressed, but that's when you can go back to the C6 and adjust it like it was in the original preset. What this does, it adds that final polish of like, okay, your vocal sounds good and it fits in the beat, but it also doesn't sound like professional and finished, right? So the soothe is just going to be like an insane final touch. You don't have to do too much, but that's what we're going to do on our vocal, right? And I kind of screwed around on these multiband. I don't know if that's back to the original settings, but that's where it was. And the template that you can purchase in the link in the description is the actual one. It comes with all of this, all of the plugins, as well as all of these other mixes and kind of the whole template for this thing as well. So there's some mastering on here, which I cover in a mastering tutorial, as well as some sends, which I've covered before. A nice tip that Baynes uses on his mixes is he uses a half and a fourth on Gunna. And again, it depends on the song. So we're setting it to fourth ping pong. What he does is adds an R compressor. So whenever you play the vocal and you don't hear any more of the vocal, it's going to raise the volume of that fourth delay. So it's kind of like automation, but just all automatic. So listen to that.
Pointers in a paddock, get my piece, pushing P. Cop new hand.
You can hear it pushing P louder afterwards because of this compressor. That's a nice trick as well. We have a hall, long, small verb, half delay and parallel compression with the 76. Again, like I said, he uses the vintage 76. You could see more of his stuff online, and there's several tutorials and live streams out there that he's given us. But overall, this is the Gunna template, and you guys can get this right now, link in the description. Let me know if you guys have any questions, and if you'd like to dissect the vocals or just play around with it, obviously go ahead and over to the store, cop it, check it out. Anyway, if you guys have any other artists or songs that you guys want me to cover or make templates of, go ahead and let me know in the comments. And until then, I'll see you guys next time.